Now's the chance where you get to ask the questions. But before we get to that, I do want to talk a little bit more about the turnovers, because that's really been a key for this team so far, is taking care of the football. Already plus three through two games.
Yeah, huge, huge factor for us. And I think that's the reason really we won the first game, was because we didn't have any and they had costly ones. And then last week, you know, obviously the pick six put us right where we needed to be. And we were able to overcome Mike's turnover. So pleased with how our guys are taking care of the ball. We've run the ball a lot in the first two games and really have only had the ball on the ground one time with one of our running backs. But you've seen the wide receivers take care of the ball. You've seen the quarterback take care of it. Really pleased with the work that our coaches have put in to get that accomplished.
We've got some questions now from some of our viewers. And Guy in Milton wants to know, last year we didn't really see the tight ends involved much in the offense. This year it's kind of been a different story. What does that do for the offense?
Well, it really occupies the middle, and it gives your wide receivers more of an opportunity to roam around. And I think, you know, Austin Blake Smith has come in and really given us a nice presence there, catching the ball. Probably could have had a couple more catches, you know, on Saturday that were some close ones. But it does free up the rest of our wide receivers, because now if you're worried about throwing to that guy, the linebackers have to stay in the box a little more. They can't fly out of there because, you're not going to throw to the guy. So we're excited about his addition and what he's brought to the team.
Ricky in Homestead, Florida, wants to know about Valdosta. Just how good do you think this team is? Are they kind of on the same level that they were last year, or do you think they're a little bit better, maybe a little down?
No, you know, last year they were a playoff team. I'd say they're on the same level this year. I think they've played two hot opponents, to start the season. Albany came out of the gates, probably one of the best teams in the country. I think they had a couple injuries and lost this last weekend. And North Alabama, we know how good they are. So I think this team is a playoff team. It has that potential. We gave them a run last year, and we want to be in the game this year, give ourselves an opportunity to come out with a victory.
You're talking about a playoff team. It seems like a winnable football game. I'm sure you guys certainly feel that it is. So I guess the natural follow-up is it too early to start thinking about the playoffs with this team, or is that up to the fans and us to do that? And you guys?
I think it's a great discussion for everybody, but again, we got a long way to go, and happy to be 2-0. And you know, the only thing I'd say to that is last year we were 2-0 after the first two games. And so if our team continues to progress and get better, you know, each week, our schedule is extremely challenging. We've got ranked opponents coming up. We've got really good opponents coming up. Again, Valdosta would be ranked if they didn't slip up in one of these games and really played a couple of close games. So, I think for us, it's always going to be that conversation is going to take place. Where are we week seven? Mm-hmm. You know, what does our team look like at that point in time?
This 2-0 does feel a little different, though, doesn't it?
Most definitely. Obviously, we talked about turnovers. I think from a special team standpoint, we're much better than we were a year ago. We're kicking the ball better. We're punting the ball better. We're returning the ball better, covering it. So there's a lot of pluses that are working in our direction right now.
I'm looking into the future, perhaps the playoffs. Manuel in North Carolina is looking ahead way down the line, perhaps, to future teams. He wants to know if there's any freshmen on this squad to kind of keep an eye on in the future, maybe that aren't playing right now, perhaps redshirting, and who do you kind of like on this squad right now that might be playing?
Well, you know, for our freshmen that we redshirted, we think we redshirt, you know, we're redshirting a really good class. We're playing two freshmen right now in Mike Dilla and Anthony Johnson. Both those guys are the two true freshmen that are playing. But we've redshirted a lot of really good players just because we had good depth at their position. And, we'll see how they play out. They're doing a great job for us on, you know, our scout team right now. So I'm excited about the future of our program based on, you know, the last couple of recruiting classes that we've gotten.
And, of course, that's where that depth starts to build as well, because you've still got a lot of guys that are going to be back from this team that are getting experience this year.
Well, I'd say probably 80% of our team right now is still sophomores or juniors. If not, you know, I mean, it's got to be somewhere close to that. We do have a lot coming back, and we're looking to continue to get better. And, you know, again, we're taking this thing, you know, the old coaching cliche, but it's so true. You just take it one week at a time, and let's get as far down the road as we can and see what happens.
Hey, still a long way to go in this season. We're only 2 weeks in, so let's enjoy the rest of it. And we've got a fun season certainly still ahead of us, and a big one coming up this weekend against Valdosta State. Mm-hmm. Good luck in that one. Always a pleasure, Coach.
Thank you very much.